What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel.
In the previous video of the series, we had a quick refresher on spanning trees and explained that the minimum spanning tree of a graph is defined as the spanning tree whose weight is the smallest among all possible tree spans of a given graph. We also implemented Kruskal's algorithm, which is one way to pinpoint the minimum spanning tree of a given graph. Now, Prim's algorithm, the subject of today's video, is another technique that identifies the minimum spanning tree, or in other terms, the minimum weighted tree that contains all of the vertices of the initial graph and no cycles. Okay, in order to better grasp the logic behind Prim's algorithm, let's, as usual, visualize it and take this weighted undirected graph as an example. The first thing Prim does is pick a vertex and set it to visited. Let's suppose we picked vertex A. Our visited vertices and edges represent the tree we are spanning, which will grow to become the minimum spanning tree of the graph. So, given our visited vertices, we are going to pick the lowest weighted edge connected to them. In our case, we only have a single visited vertex, A, and it is connected with the help of two edges to B and C, weighted 5 and 2, respectively. So we are going to pick the edge of weight 2, connecting A and C, as it is the smallest, and set both the weight and the vertex to visited. Now we repeat what we did again until all the vertices are visited. Meaning, given our visited vertices, which are now A and C, we check all the edges that are connected to them. Here we have edge AB of weight 5, edge BC of weight 3, and edge CE of weight 4. We add the lowest weighted one alongside its corresponding edge, in this case vertex B, to the tree we are spanning by setting them to visited. In the next iteration, the edge AB is not considered anymore, as you can see. Why? Well, because it no longer connects to a non-visited vertex, as both A and B are visited now. Hence, the next edge we are going to add is CE alongside vertex E. Even if the weight of AB was smaller, we don't care, as it is no longer taken into account. One iteration remains, and in this one we will add vertex D alongside edge DE. You see, it is guaranteed to have V-1 edges because every time we are setting a vertex to visited, an edge is also being set. So after visiting the very first vertex we picked, we are adding exactly V-1 edges to the tree we are spanning, V being the total number of vertices in the initial graph we started with. Now, before implementing this algorithm together, I want to briefly discuss the difference between this algorithm and Kruskal's. You see, instead of starting from a vertex, Kruskal's algorithm sorts all the edges from the lowest weight to highest and keeps adding the lowest weighted edge, ignoring those of them that create a cycle. In other words, Kruskal works with edges. It adds edges to the spanned tree with every iteration, whereas Prim works with vertices and adds a vertex edge couple to the spanned tree with every iteration. Okay, let's go ahead now and implement this algorithm. And to do this, we're going to need our famous vertex class. This class will house the data stored inside the vertex and a visited attribute. To keep track of the edge vertices pair linked to a particular vertex and be able to add them together as a couple, we created a neighbor class and an addNeighborHelper method. This class will contain, as mentioned, our vertex class and an edge class. The latter is also represented by a separate class containing the weight of the edge and an attribute to specify whether this edge was included in our spanning tree or not. Now, because the neighbor is tied to both a vertex and an edge, a neighbor is considered visited if its edge or its vertex was visited. You see, if a vertex was already visited but its edge wasn't, we don't want to revisit this vertex just because the edge linking us to it hasn't been visited yet. Similarly to what happened in the third iteration of the example we previously gave. Finally, in the vertex class, I overrode the toString method to help us later on visualize what our output, or the tree we spanned, looks like while testing our algorithm. Now, concerning the Prim class, it will take a list of vertices representing our graph as input. And in its run method, the first thing we are going to do, and similarly to the example we gave at the beginning, is if the graph is not empty, we'll set a random vertex of that graph to visit it. Here we picked the very first vertex. Next, while we still haven't visited all of our vertices, so if at least one vertex in the graph is still not visited, we need to gather all of our visited vertices, then see which pairs of edge vertex or neighbors are connected to these visited vertices, And among the unvisited or unincluded neighbors we gathered, we need to pick the one that has the minimum or lowest edge weight. That minimum neighbor is then added to the spanning tree we are generating by simply setting its vertex and edge to visited. Okay, let's go ahead now and test this implementation. To do this, I created a bunch of vertices and their corresponding weighted edges, and linked them together with the help of the addNeighbor method to represent the graph you see to the right, which is similar to the one we discussed at the beginning of the video. Then I called the run method by providing it with the vertices created. To make use of the toString method we previously implemented and visualize the output, I am simply looping over the vertices of the graph and then calling the systemOut method on them. As you can see, each vertex tells us which neighbor it is connected to in the minimum spanning tree we generated, and the results are exactly as expected and similar to what we got at the start of the video. If you want to calculate the minimum weight of the tree we spanned, all you have to do is generate a stream of all the edges included in that spanning tree, map them to their weight, and sum the values of that stream. Also, as expected, the weight we got here matches with our previous results. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.